More than 400,000 children in the U.S. suffer from epileptic seizures. Heather Jackson's son, Zakai, is one of them.
Zakai started having seizures when he was 4 months old. He has a rare, severe form of epilepsy known as Doza syndrome. And by the time he was 5 years old, he had had 500,000 seizures. Don't usually start crying this early, actually. It's an emotional day because he's 16 months seizure-free today, so I'm happy. It's a happy emotion.
Now where does it go?
Today, Zakai is talking, walking, and being homeschooled.
Right on the arrows. Nice job.
His mom, Heather Jackson, is convinced it's due to an extract found in this controversial plant.
This is where a lot of the plants are grown. There are approximately 3,200 plants in this greenhouse. Of those, about 80% are Charlotte's Web.
Joel Stanley runs one of the largest marijuana grows in the state of Colorado. It's a family-owned operation. The five Stanley brothers went into business in 2008 under the medical marijuana laws passed in the Rocky Mountain state. Jesse Stanley supervises the Denver lab.
The road from there to here is very long, a lot of failures, a lot of successes, but we started growing to help cancer patients. From cancer, it turned into multiple sclerosis, it turned into diabetes, it turned into severe pain, which was mostly THC at the time.
But soon, another less known plant compound caught the brothers' attention. Cannabidiol, or CBD. The little research they could find indicated it too may have potential healing properties. They already had a strain of plant higher in CBD than other growers. They decided to breed a strain that was even higher.
People commonly call it the hippie's disappointment, where you could smoke it all day and you wouldn't get high. But we still grew it, and so much so that it actually hurt our other crops.
Go for a dinosaur ride, Charlie.
It wasn't until the Stanleys met Charlotte Fiji that they became convinced their hippie's disappointment could really help people. Charlotte suffers from Dravet syndrome, an intractable form of epilepsy that emerges in toddlers. Charlotte, just five at the time, was having up to 300 grand mal seizures a month. A single seizure often lasting more than 30 minutes.
Joel asked me, he said, hey, there's a woman that wants to treat her daughter with cannabis. I said, you're crazy. That's just gonna end us right up in jail. Like, we're already walking that line. This is just gonna push us over the edge, get us all in orange jumpsuits.
In a healthy human, neurons fire electrical impulses in alternate and controlled firing patterns, sending signals throughout the brain. During an epileptic seizure, neurons are firing electrical impulses all at the same time, almost like an electrical storm.
Once we started it, first day, seizure-free, no seizures. A week went by, still no seizures. So then we knew we were onto something.
Renaming their strain of plant and the CBD extract Charlotte's Web, word spread quickly in the epileptic community. In order to extract CBD at a faster pace to meet demand, the Stanleys moved their extraction process into a Denver bakery they converted into a lab. Chemist Bryson Rast demonstrates the preparation of Charlotte's Web oil. First, the plant is soaked in food-grade alcohol to draw out the cannabinoids.
How long do you soak it for?
The solubility is actually quite high, so we can soak it for as short as maybe a couple of hours or even overnight.
Okay, and then you end up with something that looks like this.
The solution is heated in a rotary evaporator to maximize alcohol evaporation. That liquid is again heated and diluted with olive oil to preserve the CBD and allow for patient dosing.
What other quality control processes do you have?
We use analytical testing on site to determine the potency of the raw oil. And then we test it again afterwards once it's diluted into olive oil and double check the potency there.
None of the Stanley brothers have a medical degree. Prior to this, several worked in the oil fields of Texas. Jesse Stanley says they've discovered proper patient dosing through trial and error.
What does the high bound of that look like? Like, how would you know this? We're getting a little bit too much. We need to dial this back.
I think it's just the point of finding what works. It's not going to cause any effect, like drowsiness or anything like that. It's strictly, their body's gonna get rid of it. because it's relatively safe.
So you don't see any secondary effects? I mean, when I drink 6 cups of coffee, I know that I've had too much caffeine.
The safety profile of marijuana in general is through the roof, but we're also very safe. Because of Charlotte and the other patients, we've been able to collect data to help with dosing for other families and other people that are on the medicine.
Currently, the Stanley brothers are treating nearly 200 patients for epilepsy, but there are more than 2,000 on their waiting list. Mostly epileptics who have exhausted all medications and treatments with no success.
As bad as I feel to have to tell people that they have to come to Colorado and leave everything behind, I feel good that there's a community waiting here for them.
Many on the list come from other states where medical marijuana is illegal.
I think for some people, giving any type of marijuana extract to a child might seem kind of extreme. So what would you say to those naysayers or those skeptics?
I would say, you know, holding your child, praying for them to take their next breath is pretty extreme. Zakai is completely pharmaceutical free, so he's not on any Western medication right now. He just uses Charlotte's Web, that's all.
He was probably like a month or a couple months old baby. He didn't have his tone in his neck. He was unable to hold his neck up.
Doctors think Fahad Afif's son, Ibrahim, has a rare neurodegenerative disease called Batten syndrome. It's so difficult to diagnose. From the first seizure Ibrahim suffered at age 5, it took doctors another 5 years to identify it.
When he first started having his seizures, from that point on, he started regressing, and the doctors couldn't figure out as far as like what was wrong with him. And so they kept on treating him for seizures, and regardless of what kind of medication they gave him, it just kept on coming back to where he would have more and more seizures.
The Batten diagnosis was a tremendous blow to this family because the disease is fatal. So when Fahad found a report discussing Charlotte's Web, he made a drastic decision.
I jumped in the car and I drove straight here. Stayed in a hotel, and I just kept on calling the Realm of Caring Foundation's number because it was a number that, you know, we needed to call.
The Afifs joined the large community of families who have left their lives in other states in order to get Charlotte's Web treatment under Colorado's medical marijuana laws. They are being called weed refugees.
So the Charlotte's Web plant qualifies as hemp. Right now we're growing it under the medical marijuana program in Colorado, and it's labeled as marijuana. So it's a controlled substance. We can't ship it to a family, no matter how much people call and beg and cry for this treatment option.
Currently under federal law, all extracts found in the marijuana plant are lumped together by the DEA as a Schedule I drug. That's even though CBD is non-psychotropic.
Do you plan to take the Charlotte's Web extract into clinical trials?
We do. We feel that that's very important.
But the Stanley brothers face a lot of obstacles on their way to clinical trials, from both the FDA and the DEA. Meanwhile, a UK company, GW Pharmaceuticals, has already been approved for trials at both NYU and UCSF.
I'm testing a new drug. The commercial name is Epidiolex. The drug name is pure cannabidiol. The compound is pure cannabidiol.
After a lengthy process, Dr. Maria Cilio was granted a DEA-approved Schedule I license. In January, she started human clinical trials funded by GW Pharmaceuticals. The roughly 150 patients will all be children diagnosed with intractable epilepsy. This isn't the first study of CBD. It's been researched for more than 50 years. But according to Dr. Cilio, there is still little data verifying its safety.
People tend to see DEA and FDA as major obstacle in using this drug. Honestly, I see them as agency that the first mission is to protect the patient.
Dr. Cilio is testing CBD as a single compound. The pharmacological compound is being made from plants in the UK. This is in contrast to Charlotte's Web, which is a mixture of CBD, low amounts of THC, and other cannabinoids.
We choose to try pure cannabidiol because we thought it was just safer. We wanted to have a product that is consistent, bottle after bottle, so we know how much we are giving so we can evaluate the effect. And also we thought it was the time to do it in a way that was more scientifically sound.
How do you feel about the GW trials that are happening here in the US?
The worst thing that could happen is for that product to be too different from this one. And if it doesn't work, and then the scientific and medical communities come back and say, oh, we already looked at that, so just pass it by. That's the worst thing that can possibly happen.
People tend to see only possible benefits. And I understand, because when you have a child with intractable epilepsy, your hope never ends. But people need to understand that there are risks associated. So we want to test the drug in a scientifically sound way in order to give answers that are more than just excitement and hope.
But answers could take years. Specifically, why CBD seems to work on epileptic seizures. Two leading theories: that CBD modulates calcium influx in neurons, another, that CBD may reduce swelling in the brain, aren't the focus of the GW trials.
And I have to say that this is also common for several anti-epileptic drugs. We don't know the exact mechanism which a drug controls a seizure.
And with more physicians like Ibrahim Afif's signing off on Charlotte's Web despite the unknowns, families find themselves in a gray area, making decisions based on what seems to be helping their children today.
He's tried lots of different medications and they didn't seem to help. We already had our mindset.
I think it takes that kind of story, something we can all relate to, a sick child getting better. No one wants to deny that. For the last 30 years, activists and hippies have knocked at these government doors, whereas little Charlotte Feige and Zakai,
you did it,
busted them right down.
All right.
Only on Al Jazeera America.
A team of scientists are taking their inspiration from nature.
Technology, it's a vital part of who we are.
They had some dynamic fire behavior.
And what we do.
Transcranial direct stimulation. Don't try this at home.
TechKnow's team of experts show you how the miracles of science.
This is my selfie. What can you tell me about my future?
Can affect and surprise us.
Sharks like affection.
Catch new episodes of TechKnow on Al Jazeera America. Check your local listings or visit aljazeera.com.